What's up, YouTube? This is Dalton Gaming coming at you guys with Madden 22, Face of the Franchise, episode number 9. And we are finally versing a different team, which is the Bengals this time around. Let's go ahead and hop into this game real quick. As you can see here, we got Joe Mixon, Tyler Boyd, and Jesse Bates the third. Let's get into it. Stafford on the ring. Respectable. Yeah, this will be an interesting one. Levon Bell. This will be an interesting matchup. He ain't gonna show us the quarterbacks. Fireworks going on too. Alright. It's a special Halloween presentation. Hey, we got home advantage here. That means you're going to get the ball. Here we go.
From deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Here we go.
So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. And they'll be led out by the man running the show, Charles, their quarterback.
And I thought it was a really nice performance last week by him. 3 touchdown passes. I think that signifies exactly what he was getting done.
That's
he did
true.
Have one interception.
Yeah,
that's
make
a ratio
that far.
You say you're okay with.
If you go 3-1, you're going to be pretty happy over the course of the season. And let's face it, he'll never blame the receiver publicly. But behind closed doors, he probably told his agent, hey, what's the deal? I should have had a perfect game.
On second down, it's Bell. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down.
Charles, that's good. Let's go ahead and do our first pass.
Start believing whether you're in the midst of a special season or not. Well, now they're at 6-0. Are you still trying to tamp down the expectations in that locker room?
Well, to me, it's less about tamping down expectations and more about not getting ahead of yourself as a team. And look, they've got to play each game individually. Right? Many teams talk about being 1-0 at the end of each and every game.
Do run and play.
To me, you got to understand you cannot win the Super Bowl in October.
They'll go for it with Bell. And he's going to have
a
just
flag.
A here with a marker.
You're serious, right?
Well.
You are serious.
That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
So many different types
you're
of
a freaking kidding me.
On the defensive line now, depending on situation.
We can't have another team to mess with us
guy,
right now, man.
No matter what, though, you can't hold them.
What the frick?
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw.
Up with this.
And they'll get it up just
short. Oh, we got first and 10.
With the 44. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, and now it's first and 10.
Let's do a running play.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the
freaking
right play dialed up because defensively,
another flag.
Fourth down situations as well.
Yeah, deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. So the hand got inside the face mask that time. Looked like a pretty
I'm
easy
sick of
call.
Seeing these freaking flags.
And we
stupid.
Saw this in their loss last week. Penalties at inopportune times that led to their demise.
And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there. Nearly an opening drive, INT.
No one.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. They'll look to throw again. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Cole. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. 2 yards the loss and now third and 12.
Richard Sherman is on the.
Again, he'll drop to throw. He's going to look deep for more. Is this intercepted? It is. It's
seriously.
Intercepted.
picked off by Mike Hilton. Time to see this Bengals offense here as they get
set for their
first drive. And under center, of course, is the number one pick in the 2020 draft. Now in year number two, Joe Burrow.
And they are in rhythm on offense because of him. I mean, right now he's got everything going the way he wants to. Finding the receivers.
It's gonna be another one of them games. I feel like looking over defenses, where it comes down to the wire.
The number I lock in on before a touchdown pass isn't so bad either.
Yeah, what a game he had last week.
Right, I'm playing on pro this time.
The former second round pick, this is Joe Mixon.
Swag out there.
And they'll hit him for a loss as he's back to his 2 yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Back to Mixon on second down. And a very similar
got our safety
again. The Jets defense once more stopping him behind the line. That'll wind up as a loss on the play. So now they're staring at a third down and 12.
No, that's not safety yet. It's not safety yet.
Burrow from his own end zone. And this one caught by Cameron Bray.
Yeah,
and he gets this up just shy of the 15. Trying to find some space to operate, and now they'll have it, a gain of 12, a big first down to get away from the end zone.
God bless it.
Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Defensively here,
yeah, at least I'm doing good on these plays.
Points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to
it's
hold
annoying
them
how they keep on
doing
flag.
20 points score, give yourself you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up,
well, thank you. Come again. Thank you. That is hilarious.
Interception thrown for him. All right,
here we go.
And that really not the best decision.
Get our swagger back here.
Not at all, and that's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game, but this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake.
Oh, man.
Now let's see if they're going to turn
have
it
one
into points.
Oh, two.
A good run there on
I miscount.
First down, and it'll leave
I miscounted,
away,
man.
And two.
Not very good at counting. All right, here we go.
Back to throw.
Had to throw it. Boom.
And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, yeah. Jets.
Beautiful.
Elijah Moore, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Jets on just two plays have taken the lead. That pass also evens the ledger for the rookie quarterback. Had
that's
the interception
like, how many yards
earlier, and now he gets the touchdown throw.
The ideal touchdown interception ratio is what, 3 to 1?
Do that in our sleep.
But he's a rookie. All just right. Getting back to even is a big deal.
Took up a whole bunch of
minutes. Him as he tries to become their leader.
So they kept it on the ground, got it into the end zone.
I guess the strategy is just the run.
Teams
ball.
Treat a two-point conversion differently than if it was first and goal from the two, or I should say third and goal from the two.
I agree with you totally on that. A lot of teams treat
not that much power, though.
Farther to go and shy away from running the football. I think this is a great spot to do it because most teams play you for the pass. Go ahead and run it.
35-yard line.
And fire out.
19-yard line.
Here again comes Joe Burrow and the offense for the Bengals.
Here we go, boss.
From the early interception that led to 6 points the other way.
And when he threw the interception and he had to come to the sideline, I guarantee his first thought wasn't about the interception itself, but what could result. And I know he was thinking to himself,
but he has the ball
on
his hands.
Well, they weren't able to in this situation. Now he's got to go out for it himself, but he can't force things.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in breaking.
I bet you the Dolphins are getting annoyed by their.
And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab
the
completion for a really good pickup.
Yeah, they've been the same.
There, but it's incomplete. Tyler Boyd, the
they've been versing
receiver,
the Hawks and the Bills. It's crazy.
Well, Charles, you talk about this offense in this week 8 of the 2021 campaign. Now, normally, this would be the halfway point of the season.
Anyway.
As we all know, this now a 17-game regular season. And because of that, it seems now, maybe more than ever, getting your week to occur later in the season, that could be a pretty big advantage.
Brandon, it's always been a big advantage, and now you pointed out the possibility of becoming huge. Likely, Both teams want that later.
I'm going right here in the middle.
Because of injuries, you know, getting that rest before the playoff push, all of those things. Sometimes when you get an open date early in the season,
more tackles.
It's not really much of an advantage.
All right, quarter ended. And they're punting the ball.
Big deal, and teams definitely like it. The later, the better.
On fourth down, on is Dustin Colquitt to kick this away.
All right.
He was only asked to punt
Holy
once
cow,
in the
where was that going?
Last week as he sends
that is.
Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be
down. And they pulled the flag.
Inside the five, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
You're going to call that on me, aren't you? Yep.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
1 yard line.
So the special teams penalty costs some yardage there as they come out on first and ten.
What is up with you teams, man?
Back to throw now in his own end zone. And that gonna
be
incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he did it, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
Guys are so weak, and it's annoying.
This only up to about the 3-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
All right, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. 3rd and long coming
what
up.
What am I supposed to do with the freaking end?
I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle.
Yeah, I think that might be Frick the
you.
Spot for them. You got to try and find
Frick
some space
you.
For your punter because you don't want him backed up where he has to alter what he does.
Well, you were just alluding to it. They had the lead. Don't try anything silly. Run the ball, but they opted to throw it incomplete.
And now the punt, as a result, is really compressed, isn't it?
So I got no choice.
Have to be perfect. Snap, and he's got to get rid of it fast.
And he's
I have
able
no
to
choice.
Get it out of there, and this
but
is a pretty good kick. Returnable here from the 38. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Bengals will take over here
what
first
the frick,
and 10.
Man.
The Bengals offense getting set and ready to go again here. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
The punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully points.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Burrow on play action. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
And time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The tackle made there by Jared Davis. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion, and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Second and 10. Now it's Mixon running right, and he'll get this down only to the 18. They do get a yard there, but only a yard, leaves him with 3rd and 9 looming. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the
taking
top
me off,
rushing
man.
Defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
And they're going to get him down shy of the first at about the 13-yard line. Call it a gain of 5. 4th down now.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that
and
anytime he hand the ball to a back.
Gostkowski's kick is good. And they get on the board, trailing now 8-3.
Ish. Trying to be just like the Patriots, too.
So they do get 3 points, but that's now three drives with only the 3 points.
Now well, it seems like. Gonna win you
not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. He has not been on his A game, but his team has really picked him up. I think he probably now, second quarter, he's thinking, all right, time for me to get going.
God dang,
man. He also has to keep in mind that, you know, he has contributed. You're exactly right. Not totally on his A game, but guess what?
He's got the touchdown.
He's got a touchdown pass. Yes, he tempered it with an interception.
Yeah, he's caught something.
And he just can't get down and worry about his own stats. The team's winning. That's cause for celebration, even though there's a ways to go.
Well, now he'll be looking to contribute a little bit.
2 minute warning.
2 minutes to play in the first half of an 8-3 game.
To show me that every time.
Sheesh. Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Airing one out for Crowder, and it's almost intercepted.
Catch the ball.
Not sure he saw the free safety that time, but lucky incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down. Here's Braden Mann now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And how about this? A fake, but he will not make the first down marker. That'll be a turnover on downs. There are times to run that fake, and there are times to not run it, and this, without question, would fall in the latter category.
Well, I don't know about without question, partner. I think we should look at the analytics on this one because, oh, yeah, the analytics say, yeah, without question. You should have gone ahead and punted the football because now not only did you not get it and you really had no chance to, what a short field that you turned the ball over to the other offense.
The tight end Cameron Brate was the target. That'll bring up second down.
This game should not be this freaking close. Should not be close, man.
Burrow. He gets this one to Boyd. And
Shouldn't
be down, but not before they're inside the 25. Burrow to Boyd there for the. Cincy first.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. Touchdown, Bengals!
Really?
T. Higgins, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals have taken the lead. Kowski with the extra point, and the lead is now two.
Now we're losing.
Scoring summary: three play.
Now we're freaking losing.
Finished off with a Cincinnati touchdown. Returnable here for Davis. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Jets going to take over now late in this first half.
Freaking long play.
And a little under a minute to play. They're looking to pick up some yardage here. Maybe try and come up with a field goal to seize the lead before intermission. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And this is incomplete.
Freaking catch the ball.
Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. He's going to look deep for more. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Von Bell. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on. When he gets to the sidelines, the coach is going to check on it, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, It's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react.
Time
out, see how
whatever.
He bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen.
Trying to just be like a freaking Patriot. What the frick, man?
And that's going to be
irritating enough.
The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
Here we go. Home advantage, too, and I'm still going to freaking lose. Go figure, right?
From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. They'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Burrow looking to pass. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Now the Bengals going to signal for
their stop calling freaking
timeouts? As he'll stop it with
Jesus Christ, play the freaking game.
Half number one.
Oh my God.
Jesus Christ. Kick is good. And it's now 13-8. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just 1 play. He's going to go up top again. And the timing a bit off that time as Howard falls to the ground. So we are at halftime here on Halloween. As we'll see,
not my ball.
Halftime update after all. Seems like everyone's ready to go here for the second half in week 8 in the NFL.
You gotta be kidding.
The Bengals set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number 3. Here comes Darius Phillips out of the end zone.
Of course, it's not my freaking ball.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So here are the Bengals set to take over. They've won 2 straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on first and 10.
Of course, it's not my ball, man. Freaking really?
Now Burrow.
Taking me off.
Throw's gonna be incomplete.
That's what you guys are doing.
The defense coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Making me lose on purpose, aren't you?
Here's second and 10.
Making me lose on purpose.
Out of the gun, it's Burrow.
That's of course gonna happen.
And Burrow gonna be hit and taken down. They got him. Joe Fonacassi able to record his 5th sack of the season. This defense coming out.
God, about time. About time you show up to freaking play.
Charles may be a little refreshed and refocused
here. Jesus Christ, man.
Yeah, they did really well on that one. That's exactly what they need to keep doing if they want to change their fortunes in this game.
It'll be a
tired of doing
13,
all your freaking work, man.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah,
like
hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
7 yards on the return after a punt of 39. And that will come the offense as they take over.
Freaking cheesing me.
So they'll
it's
come
annoying.
Up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll try and get the running game going with Bell. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter. No time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
The ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least, it'll be fourth down. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. They're going to try and throw. And it's incomplete.
What the frick, man?
And they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. Well, they've got the slim deficit, decided to go for it, hoping to keep
Jesus
the football
Christ,
score.
This game ain't like
deficit, but boy, deep in their own territory like that.
Let's just say that with that call, me and the head coach,
I moved up by one difficulty.
All right, but he knew
and
he
now it turns into garbage. Jesus Christ, bro. See, I have it on pro. Can't even freaking change it back now.
So I guarantee he told his defensive coordinator, have your guys up and ready. I'm going to go for it here. If we don't get it, just make sure they're ready to go out there and bail us out.
Mixon with a first down carry. And they'll get
man,
to him
nice
just inside
too.
The 15. And even after the strong run we just saw, they're able to corral him quickly defensively. 8 yards
I'm lose this game
up,
too.
And now they'll have some options on
or
second
be my
short.
First loss of the fucking season. That's great too.
Out to the left. He's got Sample there. And the Bengals are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
19-8. Then it'll be 20-8.
They'll give it to Mixon. And he is in.
There it is.
Bengals. Joe Mixon, his 9th touchdown of the season, and the Bengals add on to their lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The offense for the Jets ready to take over. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
They go quickly here out to
what the frick, man?
And they'll get it out just short of the 45 at the 40.
Stop giving these stupid flags. Give me another one.
Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close
to home.
Oh, my
God.
If you're
so
more than
stupid.
A yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there. Final minute now in the third quarter.
Of course you're another freaking flag. What the frick?
They'll look to throw here. The Bengal pressure.
Freaking serious, dude.
Gets him the time, down he goes. Trey Hendrickson, able to record his 5th sack of the season.
And what a big 2020 season for the Saints for this third
what
round
frick,
pick
man.
In 2017 out of Florida Atlantic.
Seriously, I'm all the way freaking back here anyway.
For New Orleans last year, 13.5 sacks,
Jesus.
Which tied Aaron Donald for the NFC lead.
40 yards on the ground for him so far.
It's interesting going into this game. There was so much talk from both sides about who would control the line of scrimmage.
Oh, yes, you guys are going to give me another freaking flag, too.
That's
amazing up there.
Oh,
my God.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline.
Show me who's going to get the ball or not.
Shot in there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. The Jets try it, but the fourth down play doesn't work. And the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position.
Yeah, the game's already over.
They'll run on first down.
Seriously,
Mixon.
This game's already freaking over.
Run inside, but nothing there. Making the play defensively, Carl Lawson. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Swear. All you guys do in this freaking league is cheese. What you do?
This goes out wide for Mixon.
They get
him
stupid too.
Right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5.
Don't give me stupid flags and all this boofers. God, my last game was so freaking stupid.
Here's Burrow.
Jesus Christ.
Over the middle, complete. That's Boyd. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6.
When you have someone throwing it that well, yeah, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and look like turtle at this point. You just
I already
go ahead
lost,
and play.
Dude.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there, and on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, pretty not much. Taking a chance, not blitzing, in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Mixon. And the avenue collapsed for him as he's going to be held up short of the goal line. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden it's third and goal at the one. Third and goal, Burrow. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head. Mm-hmm. Not be able
you?
To believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
All right.
Mixon unable to find the goal line on fourth down. And the Jets are going to get the football back.
Yeah, this goes.
They'll come out throwing here on first down.
Oh, my.
This will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll throw again from their own end zone. Well, that'll be incomplete.
Gosh, you guys ain't gonna catch it.
Let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions.
What am I supposed to do?
Down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring
seriously,
pressure,
what am I
or do
supposed
they play coverage on this down?
The Jets on third down. They're struggling. 0 for 6
stupid
thus far.
Man.
This is third and 10. To Cole on the right side. And they will get to him at the 7 and stop him short of the first down marker. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th. 2 minutes left.
2 minute
to play
warning,
in this football
like I
game
care.
Here on EA
I'm already
Sports.
Freaking losing, man. Because all they do is cheese you. That's why.
So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now they go for it on fourth.
Frickin' drops the ball.
They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now, boy, the ball's going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line.
I lost.
A good chance now to put this game on ice.
Not even fair, I swear, either.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal.
They kept on giving me stupid flags. 2-yard line. 5 yards. That's all they gave us. Oh, here's a flag. Oh, wait, here's another one, too. Oh, wait, here's another one. Freaking stupid, man. NFL is going stupid. Yeah, I lost. Whatever.
Joe Mixon, his 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game.
Literally, I'm down.
Bengals are closing 16. In on a 6-2 start as they extend this fourth quarter advantage.
17-9.
Gostkowski the extra point, and that will make this a 19-point game.
Yep, further thrower.
Gostkowski now after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. Returnable here for Davis. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Another drive coming up for New York's offense. And that unbeaten record very much in jeopardy. It's been a great first few months of the season so far, but they have run into a buzzsaw here, trailing big in the fourth quarter. Not much room here as he
Fox
only gets
still
it to
running
the
because
30.
We already lost, and then
a gain of 3, second down.
Begin with. So I was like, hey, screw it.
They're gonna look to throw. He's gonna let it fly. Oh, a contested ball here, and it's gonna be caught.
Now you find
and they're gonna have this
ball
way down in Cincinnati territory. Nice. Typically with catches like that, we talk about the height of the wide receiver, but he's one of the shorter receivers in the NFL.
And it doesn't seem to matter, does it? Put the tape measure away. How about some of these guys under 6 feet tall? Antonio Brown, T.Y. Hilton, and Super Bowl 53 MVP.
Yep, got intercepted.
Picked off by Mike Hilton. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's
the and we'll walk record out of here with an L.
I think, okay, he's the guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati Bengals. And, you know, it wasn't a shutout. They did give up the points in the first quarter. But second, third, and fourth quarter, they held them scoreless.
Brandon, if you throw a shutout for quarters 2, 3, and 4, you win a lot of games in this league. And this felt a lot like, almost like if you say baseball, and the pitcher goes through the lineup the first time, and the hitters get to see him. And then they come
walk
out
of here with
the
nail,
start
people.
Blazing, right? I think they saw their best stuff in the first quarter and just shut everything down from that point on. What a great, convincing performance.
So for the Bengals, they close
the refs were definitely not on our side this time
six
around.
And 2. And they'll return home that's next good week to take on.
But anyway, the QB
Browns
rating is 20.8. 6 completions out of 22. 96 passing
yards.
They'll
try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to Indianapolis to take on the Colts.
So
for our entire crew, alongside
lost my first game after changing the
difficulty. Thanks for watching,
difficulty,
everybody. We'll see you next time.
That's, of course, going to happen. So I'll see you guys in the next one. If you guys somehow enjoyed the video, be sure to smash the like button. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out, y'all.